Hello, Jeff Keller here with Gecko Software Support. I have a new and exciting video for you here today. We're going to be talking about the Candlestick Auto Recognition plugin, a new fancy tool that goes through and actually spots the candlestick patterns directly in your chart, makes buy-sell signals, and also can be used within the Autopilot and generates all of the different formulas for you right inside your track and trade. Let's go ahead and take a look, get started, and I'll be going through and discussing specifically nuts and bolts, how this works, how you adjust it, how you really make it your own. So let's dive right in. Right now I'm looking at the E-mini S&P. I'm going to turn on my new candlestick plugin. I'm going to right click in the chart, go to chart overlays, and from here I'm going to go to candlestick auto recognition. Once I click on that, I'm immediately going to be seeing the buy sell signals in the chart. It's actually going to be labeling these patterns and signals above and below, and you'll also notice little white rectangles will actually highlight specifically which price bars, which candlesticks make those patterns, what fell into that criteria. Now we're going to be going over a lot of the preferences here, so let's go ahead and immediately switch over to our candlestick options. Now to do that, you'll see a little CNDL on the bottom right of your ruler bar, just a quick abbreviation. You can left click on that, or you can right click and select properties, and that will actually open up all of your candlestick auto recognition tools over on the right side. Now we're going to be going through and talking about the different sections here, hammer, hanging man, inverted hammer, but at the same time I need to be sure you understand the terminology I'm going to use. So first of all, let's do a quick refresher on what a candlestick is, what parts of the candlestick are called, and then we'll jump back real quick. So first things first, when you are looking at a candlestick, it is an open high low close bar. Alright, if you take a look here over on the left for candlestick A, the flat line going up here across, that is actually going to be the gap from the close to the high. This white bodied rectangle in the middle, that is going to be the body or real body of your candlestick. That is going to be created from the open to the close. And then below that we'll have a long line as well to represent how low the market went within that price bar. Now in particular, you're going to want to remember these terms. We're going to be referring to the shadows. The shadows are the flat lines that go above or below the real body. Okay? So the shadows are going to be the flat lines, and then the real body is going to be again from open to close, and it will either be filled in or hollow. Okay? Green or red. So let's go ahead and switch back over to our track and trade, and let's start taking a look at all these different features. Now, don't let this intimidate you. It's a lot of buttons, it's a lot of tools, but it's really simple once you know what it's looking for, okay? So first things first, hammer, hanging man. It's actually a pretty popular tool to have in here. All right, 2.0 and 500. This 500 or second category, which you will see for hammer, you'll see it for the inverted hammer and shooting star, you will see it for the evening star and morning star. This number here is specifically referring to the number of ticks, okay? The number of moves in the market. And that also will apply to engulfing and also the three outside up and down as well. Now, I'll go over why these numbers are so large in just a moment, but first, let's jump up to the very first spot, which is shadow body ratio. All right, the shadow body for the hammer looks like a hammer. It's got a handle, it's got a long arm, and then it's got the little hammer head on the top. So we're going to have a small body, and we're going to have a long shadow, okay? Small body, long shadow. This specifically is saying shadow body ratio. It is saying that the shadow, or long thin line, has to be at least 2 times bigger than the hammer itself, or the body, okay? So the body has to be at least twice as small in height as the length of the overall shadow below or above it, okay? Now, right here we say the short max length. We're saying what is the smallest we would allow a hammer's short section to be in ticks. The reason this is set to 500 is because we pretty much just want to see all of them. If it falls into the criteria of a hammer or hanging man and the shadow body ratio is 2 to 1, we are just fine with seeing really big ones as well, especially if we're up on a monthly chart. What if the price bar really is 500 ticks long? Not very likely, but we just want to include all the different signals that we get. Now this first section you can go through and adjust. Say you wanted to say that, you know, my body to shadow ratio, let's make it 3-to-1, all right? So I want really big shadow, small body. I want a really, more strict hammer, if you want to say. So that would be, say, a 3-to-1. Or maybe you want it to be a little less stringent. Maybe you'd say, 1.5. So it's got to be, at least 1.5 times as long, it being the shadow versus the body, okay? So you can go through and adjust that. Now this one you can reduce down. Looking in this chart, we're probably looking at an average price bar height of, I would say probably about 100 or so. You can always jump into your autopilot and cheat and take a look. But switching over here, you can actually drop this down, increase it, really whichever you would like. All right, going on, next one, inverted hammer, shooting star. Same story, just a little bit different, okay? So on this one, we've got the shadow body ratio. Again, that is 2-to-1, or you can look at it as 2 times, okay? And then, the short part of that recognition, that specific pattern, we're going to say, I'll take anything that's as big as 500. You're like, I'm just fine with that. I'll still want to see them. If it falls into the criteria of inverted hammer, shooting star, if it follows along with the 2-to-1, I'll take it, okay? So we've got that there as well. Moving on. We've got the morning evening star. Morning evening star is actually one of the more popular ones that I work with. You're going to be looking at the long body minimum length, 1 tick. Okay, this is the long, and we're saying 1 tick, meaning anything that falls into the criteria. This pretty much says we'll take anything that falls into morning or evening star, we'll take it. All right. We don't want to filter out too many by default because we want you to see anything that might pop up, and this qualifies as well. And again, the short body maximum length, we'll let it be as big as 500 ticks. Okay, we just want to see it if that pattern is there, and it will put it into the chart for you. Alrighty, dropping down, morning evening doji star. Again, long body minimum length, we're going to take everything. Piercing line, long body minimum length, again 1 and 1 for the smallest we would take, okay, which means we're pretty much taking absolutely everything. We're not filtering out any patterns that we might find. Let's go ahead and drop down for a bit, and the same will apply here for long body. We already know about the short and a maximum of 500 ticks. Let's just keep on going down for now until we get into the lower sections for the preferences on your candlestick. Alright, first thing we have here is highlight, okay? The highlight is actually referring to what I was talking to before about the little white gray dotted rectangles in the chart, where it actually highlights specifically which price bars, which candlesticks made that pattern. If you want to see it, if you don't, it's this option right here next to highlight. As you click that on or off, it will actually remove or add the actual rectangle around those patterns inside the chart window. Next up, we've got an option to show text. If you take a look at this and you know candles off the top of your head, I know I don't, but if you do and you don't need to have it label Harami Engulfing Hammer, you can turn it off, okay? You just know that those arrows, they're my candlesticks, I look at it and I immediately know exactly what it is. But that is just going to be for showing your text, turning it on and off. Alright, now let's get into a little bit more of the nuts and bolts of it, so to speak. We have options here for invert arrows, one by for each cell, show moving averages. Alright, let's start with invert arrows. It is exactly how it sounds. We are literally going to reverse the buy sell arrows that we receive. Now this normally will occur if you have arrows that just aren't matching up. It's not necessarily that's going to happen every time, but here would be an example here on the 60 minute chart. Just for what we have here, a down and up, if you notice that on a specific time frame you see a pattern of seeing, quite frankly, opposite direction for the arrows, then use that to your advantage. If you notice that, over the history of this chart, this specific time frame or these specific markets, I seem to get a nice reversal. It's almost like I wish it was in reverse. Do it. Click invert arrows and, then play it forward. Now at this point, take a look at the chart. We've got the 60 minute ES, and now we've got a buy right at the base, right, when this trend is starting, and then we get a sell right up here near the peak, right at the top of this, which looks like almost a triple top. So that's a triple top formation. We get it right at the head there, and that's not a bad place to be considering the drop that followed right after. So invert arrows literally just means I want to switch everything over. Now let's go back over to my daily, and let's take a look at the next option for the CNDL, the candlestick, and that's going to be one buy for each cell. One buy for each cell means that Every single time I get a buy or sell signal, don't make another one pointing the same direction at all until I get a new signal to either go in reverse, sell, or at the opposite, buy. Don't make it again. Let me show you this one more time. Take a look. One sell, one buy, one sell. So one buy for each sell. If I turn this off, we can actually get multiple signals in a row pointing the same direction. So notice Harami right here pointing down to sell. Right after it, we get a three inside down. We actually get another signal pointing down. So two shorts in a row. Over here, engulfing, followed immediately by a three outside up. Three white soldiers, Harami, engulfing, engulfing. So it actually will give you several signals in a row, and it will not necessarily just wait for one by one cell, one by one cell. So that's actually really interesting as well. One of the most important things about the Candlestick auto recognition is going to be your moving averages. Candlestick recognition is almost always based off of an overall trending market or direction. And to help spot those trends or overall direction, we put in a moving average. And the moving average is on by default at all times. Okay? Right now you don't see it in the chart, but we specifically choose whether to look for long or short candlestick patterns based on a moving average. And let me show you what that looks like. Right here you see show moving averages. Take a look. All right, we're going to click that on. We've got one white, one light green, 14 and 28, both simple moving averages inside your chart. Now, what this does is it sets an overall trend, overall bias for which direction of candlestick patterns we're going to look for. So every single time the moving averages crosses over, we're going to look for the opposite direction of signals. To give you an example right here, we have actually right at this exact point right here, we have a crossover of the moving averages. Just before that, we get a sell signal. Once the green and white have crossed over, green above white, we are only looking for bullish or long price bar patterns. And right here, we spot one and we get an arrow pointing up, we get a buy signal. Then over here, take a look. Right here, we get another crossover of the moving average. We get a change in that overall trend. And as soon as that happens, from then on, we are looking for bearish or short patterns from the candlestick. And right here, we almost immediately get one. The engulfing gives us a short right after that. Okay? So moving averages are very important. They determine your overall trend, your overall bias, because there are a lot of candlestick patterns to spot. If we didn't have an overall trend, it doesn't work as well with the candlesticks, and they were always based to be working with an overall trend and bias. So the moving average is handy, okay? And you can fine tune and adjust it as well. Personally, I like exponential. It just works for me. That's my style. That's what I like. I like exponential. So that's what I put in. And as you can see, it actually moved our sell signal way up, got us a little buy signal here. Not to make me right out of the bat, I actually hadn't tried that before we just did this, but that's up to you. Exponential is just something I like, and it happened to make me look really smart just now. Alright, so we've gone over all the regular preferences for the candlestick. Let's go over something a little bit fancier, a little bit more entertaining, so to speak. Anyone with the autopilot? Autopilot is the little picture of the pilot's head up here in the top right. The candlestick auto recognition plugin can be used with the autopilot. Okay. It makes buy-sell signals, the autopilot can use it, and we can choose to have it set up in the candlestick section. Now, this candlestick plugin is the very first to get a new feature that no other indicator has, and that is the ability to QCalc each individual section of the candlestick preferences. I'm going to go ahead and drag open this preferences tab and take a look here on the side. Every single section has its own quick calculator QCalc option. Now, for anyone that's unfamiliar with the autopilot, it is a backtesting system that goes through and backtest creates a trading strategy based on the arrows on the screen, and it gives you results for the trades, and if everything goes well, goes according to plan, you tell it to start trading, you go to sleep, and it trades for you while you sleep, or while you go to work, or while you go to the park or beach, hopefully if it goes well enough in those trading. So, really nice to have. Over here in the preferences, you can literally QCalc every section of the candlestick plugin. So right now, our hammers, 2-to-1 with a max length of 500. Let's QCalc it. We left click on QCalc, starts chugging along, going through all the different possibilities, options. It will be using the candlestick entry and exit based on the autopilot window, and once it's finished, it will actually go through and show us what trade results would I have got if I had traded this specific hammer setting for the last 2 months, 3 months, 6 months, over the last year, the whole history of the contract, if I'm looking at this daily. It'll actually go through and Q-calc it, and you can click on every single one. It's fantastic. We've never done that before, and it's really handy, because I don't like clicking through options one at a time, especially with decimals. All right? So, new candlesticks. Very fun, exciting. We definitely hope that you like it, and we are more than happy to give it to you. If you'd like to start up a free trial, let us know, and we'll be more than happy to do that for you. Have a great day, everyone, and I will talk to you next time.